Hi, I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show. I'm trying to change
it. Dave, what's happening today?
I'm trying to change it this week. It looks good in the edit, I hope.
Okay.
First up this week is Toosh. Toosh, which means your bottom.
Does it really?
I had no idea. I had to do some research and find out what Steve was referring to when he called this product Toosh.
And normally when you do research, you get things correct.
That's right. Yeah, we'll come to that later.
Okay.
There's a really great concept with this. A really, really great and exciting concept.
I know you're really excited about this.
I love this. This is one of my favourite products for a long time. I love this whole thing of doing effects with your business card.
Well, you've got something similar to this on your lecture DVD, haven't you? Where a sort of two-drawing thing where they change
two
places.
Two drawings change places. Steve's done something very clever here. With the construction of the Toosh routine, it does mean that one of those sign drawings can be somewhere else already. So at the moment, I know you know what I'm talking about, but for the benefit of the viewers, at the moment that you show one sound design, and another sign design
with their signatures on
with their signatures on two separate designs. In actual fact, one of those designs is actually somewhere else at that point.
And in the routine, it's under someone's bottom.
It doesn't need to be.
It can be anywhere.
It can be in a wallet. It can be underneath a glass. In fact, I was buzzing with this all weekend. Like, where could you put it?
Phone calls every 5 minutes. How about we stick it here? How about we stick it there?
You could put it here. You could put it under a glass and then do the effects like Steve explains. And then the card, their signed card, their picture is under a glass.
And it's incredibly clever. Mr. Haynes, I've never met you, but this is such a genius
method. In fact, we're going to give this an award. Before we mark it, we're going to give this an extra award. This is going to be the first Worker of the Week.
Well done, Steve. You got the Worker of the Week award.
This is brilliant.
And
it's really
a long DVD. It's like over an hour long, isn't
it? There's lots of extras on there. I wasn't too fussed with a lot of the extras, to be honest. Things with a wallet that you get with it to keep all your cards
in. Some people might like it, but I mean, it's the main routine. That's the bread and butter.
Points to remember. You do need to have business cards to do this that have got a blank space on the back so you can do the drawings, or you can just do it with blank cards as Steve does in the explanations. Other things to consider, the drawings aren't done by the spectators, but this is well covered in the presentation, but they're your drawings, and they're signed by the spectator.
I don't think, as long as the cards are signed, I don't think it's an issue that you've done the drawings. I know it would be nice, but...
You can see the reaction from people on the video. They're absolutely stunned by it. I was stunned. I was stunned at the potential of this routine. It gets our Worker of the Week, and I'm going to give this 91%.
That's excellent. I'm going to give it 91% as well. Well done, Steve. Right, so the last routine, Dave was very excited about it. I was very excited when I opened up this one. We're looking now at Twisted Blizzard by Aaron DeLong.
You get like a deck with it. Custom printed bicycle deck.
And you get a very nice DVD.
A DVD.
It's well explained. Aaron DeLong comes across as a very good teacher. In fact, he explained it so well, I opened it this morning and I can do it already.
You can do it already?
I can do it already.
Can we get off the sticks? Can we see it now?
Yeah, let's do it. Right then, Dave, got a trick with a pack of cards here for you. 52 cards in a deck. Name a four of a kind.
The fives.
The five, you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, so we've got the five of clubs, the five of hearts, the five of spades.
There's no fours there. Can I name anything?
You can name anything.
Right, okay.
Absolutely no
force. Psychological mind stuff going on there.
No force at all.
Right, go for it.
Right, so a pack of cards. You name the fives. Now I'm going to put them down on the table. This is all about choices. Okay,
right.
You've got five of clubs, five of hearts, five of spades, five of diamonds.
Right.
Name a suit, which one?
Five of clubs.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Change your mind?
No.
Okay. So think about it. You could have named any value, and you named the fives.
Yes.
Then you could have named any suit.
Yeah.
And you named the five of clubs.
Yes.
Was there any reason why you ended up on the five of clubs?
I don't think so.
Because you did really well.
Right.
No, seriously. Because look at this. Five of clubs. It's the only one that's printed.
Right.
In fact, it gets better than that. Because remember, I took the cards out of the deck.
Yeah.
Well, check this out. Every single card in the deck is blank. There's only one card printed all the way through, and that's the card that you named, the five of clubs.
That is very good.
Isn't that a miracle?
And
that's great. No rough and smooth, nothing like that. Instant reset, ready to go again. There's only one negative I can find with this.
What's the negative?
If you're working
I'm
in a
not
restaurant,
seeing it so far.
If you're working in a restaurant, you do have to put things down on the table.
Yep,
if it's cluttered, you're going to kind of struggle. You don't need a close-up map, but it helps. The spread at the end you can do in the hands, but you do need to put this down here. So if you've got a very cluttered restaurant table,
that's
an issue. But that is the only issue.
Not much of a negative for that effect,
I
tell you.
It's not. It's an instant reset. It's ready to go. It's incredibly easy to do. I
a
really
lot of people
just open
have problems with like showing like a gimmick deck, you know, a blank deck, but I do a routine already, a Greg Wilson ambitious card routine, all the time, and I use a blank deck, so actually if my spectators saw this later on, they're not going to think there's anything strange about it.
I'm the same.
What's going on this week? We've had two reviews already.
And they're both good.
I can't find anything
well,
bad.
Well, here's a negative for you. He put a bonus routine on here called White Trash.
Yes.
Very aptly named routine, I think.
So out of this world?
It's out of this world where you divide the reds and the backs and the blanks.
Yeah.
And it takes a routine which I think is already very good, and it overcomplicates.
It's a bonus for bonus sake.
Yeah, I don't think it needed to be on there, but
that's just brilliant.
It's great, isn't it?
Custom printed. It's
custom printed. It'll last you a lifetime.
I can't think of anything bad to say. In fact, I'm going to give that 87%.
I'm going for 90%. Really good effect. Well done, Aaron.
Well done. Right, occasionally we get quite a bit of feedback about our show, and we get people posting on Facebook, and occasionally we get the odd person posting a YouTube video response.
Mm-hmm.
And we were a little bit hurt and a little bit scared when we got a video from this guy.
Okay, so this is probably really, really strange, and to be honest with you, it's been bugging me to do this for a while, and I asked a couple of guys and they said, yeah, go ahead and do it, so I'm going to be the one to do it here. If I don't look at the camera all the time, I'm sorry, I wrote down a crap load of stuff that I really need to talk about. The Wizard product review, I'm not exactly sure what the date was, but I recently watched it, and I don't care whether it's old or new. Kind of went on a rant about Autograph. Craig Petty has released three effects that I could find that were widely like advertised, and the other guy has one. I put in Justin Miller in Google, and on the first page I saw Captured Bullet, Factory Sealed, M5, Silver Dream, Army of 52, Seven Deadly Slights, Cloak, The Loops DVDs, Autograph, Strolling Hands, and that is just the starter. Picture all of the effects that are in all of his lecture notes. Okay, I have all of these. I literally have all of these, and I love all of them. Unfortunately, I don't have the newest lecture notes because I don't have PayPal and I can't get a hold of them, although I wish I could, just because I'm dying to know what's in there, so hopefully he'll come to Toronto. If not, I guess I'm kind of screwed. So that's just my little rant on the Wizard product review. They're probably highly respected by a lot of magicians. They're not respected by me at all. At all. I have absolutely no respect for anybody who would put down JM like that. He is, in my opinion, the best magician, hands down. In modern day right now, he's up in the ranks of Garcia and all those guys.
He was pretty scary, that guy.
Yeah, he didn't
with
even
the
know
dark
who you
lighting
were.
In fact, we had a few comments on the cafe. A guy called Steve went on and said he reminded him of Kathy Bates in Misery.
Yeah, he kind of had a bit of a single white female vibe to it.
Yeah, I'm glad he's in another country. This
I'm also glad that he
me.
Seems to like Justin Miller instead of us, because I think it's worse for Justin than it is for us,
yeah,
to be honest.
Because there was a guy outside my house the other day going through my bin, and I just had to make sure that it wasn't this guy. But it's okay, you know, because we've got our own crazy fan as
we
well.
We do have a crazy fan.
This guy's from called Mark, and he's from Skipton.
What did they ever do to you? Leave World Magic Star alone. It's not fair what you're doing to them. I just want to leave.
Right, so that's Mark. I'm glad he's on our side.
Yeah,
but,
because he, although crazy, he doesn't come across as crazy as I Manipulate Cards.
I Manipulate Cards is a little bit scary. I'm just glad there's only four flights a day from Toronto, where he lives.
Yeah, you've actually looked into that as well, haven't you?
We've researched him. We've done a little bit of research. But it's not that bad now, because a guy called James Howells, good friend of ours, actually got in touch with him, and it seems that he's actually changed his opinion now, and he reposted this video.
First, let me say, the Wizard product review, I love it. Craig Petty is awesome. Let me tell you something. He is, in my opinion, the best magician, hands down, in modern day right now. He's up in the ranks of Garcia and all those guys. His hands are way too entertaining to even care about anything else around. He's amazing. There's nothing bad, I think, that he has ever put out. And his coins. You know, if you've ever watched Craig Petty do coins, Or if you're a coin magician, you probably do something that he influenced. Craig Petty is awesome. Awesome, awesome. Just saying.
Right, so this is Cody Fisher's restaurant opener. What he does, he walks up to the table, he takes a spoon off the table, he concentrates a la sort of Uri Geller, and what he does, he actually proceeds to bend that spoon and then he hands it out to people like that.
That's just great. That is really strong and commercial.
It's a good effect. There's really not that much to talk about.
He comes across as very, very well read when it comes to restaurant magic. I know he's done a lot of work with restaurants before and various books and so on and so forth. And he gives a lot of that advice over on the DVD. And what he says is completely right. You know, if you're a restaurant worker and you pick this up, you are not going to be disappointed.
Yeah, I kind of threw that routine together there, but it's a lot more commercial. The way that Cody does it is very direct, very straight. I don't like the wand.
No, me neither. It kind of gives you a bit of a kid's magician type look to
you. I don't want to walk up and have a magic wand in my hand, I'm afraid, but you could easily re-routine this.
To be honest, very quickly, I actually really liked the bonus routines on there as well. There was an ambitious card finale that he published in MUM a few years ago, where the deck is wrapped up with a rubber band and a dollar bill, and it visibly appears face upon the deck. I thought that was excellent.
Really nice routine. Yeah. It's a great gimmick. It's obvious he's worked it. There's lots of knowledge in this DVD. If you like what you see, you're going to get no surprises here.
Yep.
I'm going to give it 84%.
I'm going to give it 86.
Right, before we have a quick look at the teaser trailer for our next product, Sleeve Star from Wizard FX Productions and David J, and some words from Greg Wilson, let's have a look at our final review, which is Flight Case by Peter...
I think it's Egging.
Egging. He's from the Netherlands.
He's very hit and miss, in my opinion. Right. Some of his stuff I haven't been impressed with at all. Other stuff I've thought was very good.
What did you think to this?
I thought it was very good.
It's very good. He's got a nice card to box here. And it's a lovely moment because the dirty work is done on a real offbeat moment.
It really is,
It's very clever.
It's quite nice. As you're showing that the box is empty and there's nothing that could be gimmicked about it, that's when you're loading the card.
Yeah, very, very clever.
Very, very, very good routining.
He's not got the best rubber dub vanish in the world, has he?
No, not at all.
If you see that, he needs some work on that,
seriously.
He really
does, yeah.
But the actual construction of the routining to cleanly put the card in the box, at the moment they're seeing it empty, it then goes into their hand, the spectator puts their other hand on top, you can vanish the card with a good rubber dub vanish, and then... they lift up their hand.
And they're holding the box the whole time.
And it looks fantastic as the card comes out of the card case.
It really does.
It really does look good, and it's their signed card.
And what's nice about it is the box is normal in terms of you could have it as a normal box.
You get a gimmick with it. You do get a gimmick.
Yeah, but what I mean is you could use it as a normal box. So you could carry your deck around in it, and any time you want to actually do this routine, you've got access to the gimmick to be able to do it.
Immediately after the performance, if they go, let me have a look at that box.
Yeah.
There's
and
nothing
it's an
to
instant
find.
Reset. It's ready to go, no angle restrictions, perfect for restaurants. The DVD is very no frills.
What's going on this week, Craig?
I don't know,
there's nothing to really go, oh, we didn't like this, which is not our style normally, but we like...
The only thing I can think of is the DVD is very no frills. You know,
yeah,
the camera work was
a bit of a Chris
shoddy.
Webb DVD.
It was, yeah, in the
garden,
back garden.
In the back garden with the birds, that sort of thing. If you want to do card to box, this is well worth having a look at.
Can't
very,
think of a better
very
way to do it.
Nice idea.
Yeah.
I'm going to give this... 84%.
I'm going to be at 84 as well.
Guys, thanks so much for watching the Wizard product review once again. You can follow us on Facebook.
www.facebook.com/worldmagicshop.
Our YouTube channel is youtube.com/worldmagicshop.
Or you can go onto iTunes and search Wizard Product Review. You've got the entire back catalogue on there and you can download all of them and subscribe. And finally, if you go to www.wizardproductreview.com, you can see all the latest shows as well.
Fantastic. And here coming up right now is the teaser trailer hosted by Greg Wilson of Sleeve Star by David J and Wizard FX Productions.
Hope you enjoy it.
There's one thing I need to say about Sleeve Star. Actually, one word. Actually, three words. Brilliant. I want this thing. I want it now. I'm freezing. I'm hungry. I'm tired. I just finished a lecture. I've been in this parking lot with all my magic buddies and my new magic star or sleeve star friend for 2 hours. 2 hours in this parking lot talking about this bloody thing. Here, you can tell I'm in England now. Everything's bloody. It's amazing. It's stunning. I want one, and I'll put it in all my clothes and my entire wardrobe. So there you have it. Ba-ril-yent.